to disassemble, repair and assemble your Nokia Lumia 720, you will need a T2 and a T4 Torx star type screwdriver, a small bladed screwdriver and a plastic separation tool. You can use a plastic knife, guitar pick or your thumbnail. You'll also need some adhesive if you're replacing the screen or the rear casing. Make sure the phone's shut down. Now remove your SIM tray. And the micro SD tray. Using your T2 screwdriver, undo this small screw on the top. This is the only screw this size, so you can't get it mixed up with the others. Now we need to separate the rear casing from the screen. If the phone turns back on, make sure you shut it down. Using your thumbnail or a plastic tool, work your way around the top edge, trying to lift the rear casing away from the screen. You can use a guitar pick or a plastic knife. Keep trying to lift this top corner away. And once you have the corner released, the rest comes away quite easy. If you're fitting a new rear housing or you're having problems with your headphone socket, then this can be removed by gently lifting this circuit up. And there's some adhesive holding the headphone socket down. Once you get your screwdriver in the bottom, you can lift it away. This is held on by this small piece of adhesive. If your new casing doesn't come with this antenna, you'll need to remove it and place it into your new case. You can use some heat to soften this adhesive. When you fit it to your new housing, you need to apply adhesive here and here. Don't apply too much, or it will squeeze out the sides. Then replace the headphone socket. Make sure that circuit is pushed all the way down. This antenna can be removed and exchanged over to your new housing. And this very long antenna on this side can be removed and exchanged over to your new case. This flex cable is for the docking port pins you can see on the rear. You can use some heat to make this easier and lift this away from the case. very strong double-sided tape holding this on. And exchange this over to your new case, starting with the pins. Make sure the adhesive is nice and flat. And push those pins through the case. Double check and make sure that the flex cable lines up with the plastic pins in the case. This is the LED flash and forward facing microphone grille. You can remove this and exchange it over to your new case. If you need to remove or replace the camera lens, push through from the back. And then you can either exchange it over to your new case or fit your replacement. These contacts are for the NFC antenna. And again, this can be removed with a bit of heat to help soften the adhesive, and then exchange it over to your new case. To remove or replace the battery, start by disconnecting the flex cable using a plastic tool to prevent any shorts. Now we need to use some heat to help soften the adhesive that holds this copper heatsink in place. You can use a fan heater, hairdryer, or here I have a hot air heat gun. Try and get the temperature to around about 60 C. Try and get the copper tape nice and warm. And using a pair of tweezers or a screwdriver, lift the copper tape away. This can be done cold, but you'll find it much more difficult. Keep the heat source going, as there's double-sided tape holding the battery in place. Once you've released the tape, you can switch off the heat source. Lift the battery out from this side. If you're replacing the battery, you can keep it nice and warm and peel off this copper heatsink and place it onto your new battery. If you are replacing the display, you'll need to remove the main board and the bottom USB flex. Using your T4 Torx screwdriver, undo these three screws. These are the same size as the four screws at the top, so don't worry about getting them mixed up. This contains the 3G GSM antenna, and the connections are here, and your loudspeaker. If you're replacing the loudspeaker, you can lift it away from the double-sided tape. And when you fit the replacement, make sure the tape is sitting down nice and flat. When you place it back in, make sure the contacts go towards the battery. Now undo the four screws that hold the main board in place. Try and be careful around these sprung antenna connections, as they're very easy to bend. Now we can lift the USB board away. There's some double-sided tape holding this in place. Using a thin blade, try and separate the double-sided tape holding the flex down. And over this side, you'll find this small amount of double tape. Now disconnect the volume, power and camera switch flex cable. And gently lift the main board up. But don't lift it away too far just yet, as the proximity sensor is still attached to the screen. Using a small bladed screwdriver, gently lever this away, and now the main board is almost free. Make sure the USB board is completely free. And finally, disconnect the main screen display flex cable. And put that aside. If you have a new screen that doesn't come with the metal frame, we need to lift this double-sided tape away from the flex cable. If you need to remove or replace the earpiece, make sure you lever from this side and when you put your replacement in, make sure the contacts go towards the center. This is the two-stage camera button, power, volume down, up, and your electronic compass. If you need to exchange this over to your new screen, you can use some heat to soften the adhesive and gently lift the flex cable away from the frame. If the screen is not too badly shattered, you can use a sucker tool to help remove the screen from the frame. This is from a car phone windscreen mount. You could use a sat nav or possibly a fridge one. Switch on your heat source and try and get the temperature to between 60 and 70 C. Once the screen's nice and warm, we need to separate the digitizer flex from the frame. Don't worry too much about any damage, as your new screen will come with a new flex. I'm being careful here so I can reuse this screen again. Make sure the display cable is completely free. And using a thin blade, try to separate the screen from the frame. If the screen is shattered, then you'll have lots of glass pieces falling off. You could place some tape over the screen to help prevent the glass splinters from going everywhere. Working your way around the outside edge. And then twist. And lift away. Now switch off the heat source. If you are trying to replace the digitizer touchscreen separately from the display, you will need to use plenty of heat and a strong thin wire to separate the digitizer from the display. This can be quite tricky, as the optical adhesive that's used between the screen and the display is this clear optical adhesive, which is extremely sticky and difficult to cut through. I will try and cover this kind of repair in the future. Check the screen frame is free from any leftover adhesive. Before you fit your replacement screen, apply some adhesive around the outside edge. Try not to use too much, just a very thin bead is all you need. try not to use super glue, as it tends to leave white marks on the casing. And it's quite brittle, so if the phone's dropped, it normally breaks the bond and the screen falls out. This flexible adhesive is pretty good for securing your screen. Now feed those flex cables through into the frame, making sure they come all the way through and are not trapped at all. And the Digitizer flex cable, feed that through. And again, make sure the cable's not trapped. Gently push the screen into place. Clean off any excess adhesive. Now replace that double-sided adhesive over the flex cable. If you remove the earpiece, place that back into the housing, making sure the contacts go towards the center. If you're having problems with the main microphone or USB port, you can replace this circuit board. Start by disconnecting the 3G GSM antenna flex cable. Keep twisting and lifting that away. And then unplug the cable from the main board. To remove the main camera, push it through from this side. And disconnect from the main board. This is the proximity and ambient light sensor and your forward-facing camera. You can remove this by lifting away from the main board. This micro SD card tray can be replaced using a hot air soldering iron. Under this rubber cover is the forward facing microphone. And this is the vibrating motor. This SIM tray can be replaced using a hot air soldering iron to heat all the contacts at the same time. Now replace the main camera. If you have a new one, you'll need to put a bend in the cable so it goes round into the hole. Now replace the proximity sensor and forward facing camera. Reconnect the USB and microphone flex cable. And finally, reconnect the 3G GSM cable. Now replace the Digitizer flex cable onto the casing. Make sure it lines up with this small pin in the case. And try and remove any finger grease from the gold contacts. Now plug the display cable back onto the mainboard. Try and make sure you can hear it snap down into place. Gently lay the mainboard back onto the frame. And it's very important we make sure this proximity sensor is located properly on the two pins and make sure it's pushed all the way down or the screen will go blank during voice calls. Now replace those four screws into the mainboard. If you took off the side key flex cable and place that onto your new screen frame, making sure you line up the small hole in the flex cable with the pin on the case. Check that all the holes in the flex cable go over the pins. This helps the keys line up with the rear casing. Give it a nice push down to make sure it's stuck in place. Now reconnect the cable. Now replace the loudspeaker antenna assembly. Making sure it locates fully into the frame. And replace those three screws. Don't do the screws up too tight, or you might break the antenna housing. Make sure the antenna cable is plugged in and sitting down nicely. And if it's come unplugged this end, keep moving it around until it lines up. And you can feel it's pushed fully down into place. Now replace the battery, putting the top in first, and bring it down. Give this copper heatsink a nice push down. This helps sink the heat away from the processors. And make sure these sprung antenna connections are not sticking up too high, or too low. Now reconnect the battery. And before you put the rear cover on, you can make sure it's working by pressing the power button. Once you're happy that's working, place the screen down into the bottom of the cover first. And don't push it fully closed yet, as you need to push the SIM tray button down so it goes under the cover. Now you can insert your micro SD tray. Replace the small T2 screw. And finally, your SIM tray. The phone will probably restart when you insert your SIM card. Make sure everything's working okay. If you find your replacement screen doesn't work properly, don't panic. This is quite a common problem that is normally solved by performing a factory reset. This will recalibrate the screen and it will normally work okay. If it doesn't work okay after a factory reset, then you probably have a faulty new screen and you need to contact the seller for a replacement. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to give a thumbs up and subscribe, and I shall make some more.